Salutations, second graders, and welcome to Math Lesson 29 on our mobile learning platform. Today we'll be going over tenths. We'll be on page 309, 310 of your math packet. Boys and girls, let's just review a little bit about yesterday. And while I'm getting the review out, go ahead and get out your math packet so you're ready to work with me. Here we are, friends. Just a quick review from yesterday. In fraction form, this is 1/10. But if I'm using decimals, the number just to the right of the decimal point is the tenths place. So this number shows 1/10 all as well. Now, just as another review or the same type of review, we have a number line that shows the ones spot and the tens spot, and we know if we keep going to the left, we would get hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, right? But when we go to the right of the decimal, to the right of the one spot is going to be the decimal point. We always read that as and to the right of that, we have the tenths and the hundredths spot. So today, friends, we're looking at hundredths. Let's get your math paper in front of you. It looks like this, and it has a jackrabbit. Let's read along together at the top of the page. It says a jackrabbit jumped 6 feet. It is able to leap 10 feet. The jackrabbit leaped 6/10 of its longest leap. Then if we look at the chart or graph here, it says each bar is 1/10. The shaded bars are 6/10 of the total. Now, we know from working with fractions that if we count that out, we would see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of 10 total, right? Because there's 4 over here. And you can write 6/10 as a decimal. Wow, just like we just said, the decimal number is 0.6 or 6/10 is how we read that. A tenth is one part out of 10. So if we look at number 1, we have 3 out of 10, which then becomes 3/10 if we look at it in fraction form. And we would write that as 0.3 in decimal form. Therefore, we would have 3/10. Are you ready? Because now it's our turn. All right. Max, I want to do 7 out of how many? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7 out of 10. So how many am I going to color in? 7. Right? Okay, so I have 7 out of 10 is the same as 7/10 or 0.7 or 7/10. So far, so good, second graders? All right. Now let's go 9 out of how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 9 out of 10 or 9/10 or 0.9, which is how do we say it? 9/10. And we would write right here, 9/10. All right, second graders, stay with me. We're doing great, and we're going to continue working on this page together. Let's see what we have. Write the fraction and the decimal for each picture. How many are colored in, friends? 2 is my numerator. What's my denominator? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I have 2/10. How would I write that as a decimal? 0.2. Very good. Okay, number 5. Let's go with Sean. How many, Sean? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is my denominator. How many are colored in? 7/10. Good. And how would I write that? 0.7. Nice work. Do number 6, please, Bradley. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many are colored in? 8 out of 10 or 0.8 to be 8/10, right? Good. All right. And Valentina, do the last one for me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, and how many are colored in? 5 out of 10 or 5/10. Right on? Good job, second graders. Turn your paper over. You're going to write the decimal number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many are colored in? How do I write that decimal then, please, Bradley? 0.4, 4/10. Good. Do the next one for me, please, Jax. 0.1, 1/10. Good. And do the last one for me, please, Trinity. 0.9. Awesome. All right, writing the decimal for the fraction, Joshua. 0.2, 2/10. Good. Next one, Tessa. 0.8, 8/10. Next one, Mila. 0.3, or 3/10. Next one, Jacob. 0.6, or 6/10. Good job. Now we're going to relate the fraction to the decimal. We're going to show how they're the same. So let's go with Sonia. How would I do this one? 9/10 is how it reads, and that's how we'd write it. 9 out of 10, right? Good job, Jackson. Do the next one. 6 out of 10, or 6/10. Good. Emma, 1 out of 10, or 1/10. Tino, 4/10. Good. Kylie, 5/10. Good job. Quincy, write the decimal for 5/10. We are going to go 0.5. Good. Okay, how about this one, Reagan? 0.8. Good. What about this one, Giovanni? 0.2. Good job. All right, be ready. Problem solving path. Here we go. The Very Large Array of Radio Telescope is located in the desert near Sirocco, New Mexico in the United States. Visitors can take a 45-minute tour. 9 out of 10 visitors enjoy the tour. What part of the visitors enjoy the tour? So friends, the question we're answering is what part of the visitors enjoy the tour? It says 9 out of 10. What is 9/10? How would I write that? Max. 0.9, so 9/10 of visitors, right? Good job, because visitors is our unit, okay? Now, 7 out of 10 students who visit the Very Large Array want to return the next year. What part of the students want to return? My question is, what part of the students want to return? Circling 10, circling 7. It would be 7 out of 10, but we have to write it as a decimal. So how would I do that? 0.7. So 7/10 of the students, right? Okay. All right, second graders. I hope that that helps you get familiar with decimals. We will be working with them some more this week. Have a beautiful day. I'll see you soon for some more mobile learning. Bye now.